The sixth key to embracing your spiritual and material sides and taking inspired action is that of using both your left and your right brain. I know it sounds a bit weird, but hang on with me here. The left brain, right brain theory tells us that each side of the brain controls different types of thinking. For example, a left brain person is more logical, objective, and analytical, while right brain people are more intuitive, subjective, and thoughtful. I would define myself definitely as a left brain person based on what people around me are saying. In Bangkok, I'm studying Thai language. Because I'm more left-brained, I will remember words and translations easily, but I don't actually apply them. Once I realized this, I incorporated my right brain by imagining the words I study more vividly, add images, colors, and sounds to them. As a direct result, I'm able to retain many more translations, and I also apply them in real life than just remember it consciously. If you only know but you don't apply things, eventually the knowledge that you have will fade away and you forget it. For example, at high school we had to learn the French and German language. Often for tests we had to remember hundreds of strange words that even natives hardly use. As a result, we used our left brains to quickly remember the words, but then after the test you quickly forget it all. However, there was one teacher who would play games and let us watch movies in German. It is funny that more than 10 years later, I still remember most of the words from that particular class. The teacher knew, either consciously or unconsciously, the power of integrating your left and your right brain more effectively. It's so sad that most high schools and universities are set up this way, with bombarding their students with unnecessary knowledge that they will never apply in real life. Now you know more about the left and right brain, you are able to remember more and to do more with the knowledge that you acquire. Often graduates have a hard time blending in after graduation because this big difference between using the left brain at school while using the right brain at work. Both spiritual and wealthy people are excellent users and incorporators of both their left and their right brain. They are completely aware and conscious of their thoughts and actions. In general, the left brain is dominant in language. It processes what you hear and handles most of the duties of speaking. It also carries out logical and mathematical computations. When you need to retrieve a fact, your left brain pulls it from your memory. The right brain is mainly in charge of spatial abilities, face recognition, and processing music. It performs some math, but only rough estimations and comparisons. Your brain's right side also helps you to comprehend visual images and it makes sense of what we see. It plays a role in language, particularly in interpreting context and a person's body language. For problem solving, the left brain uses logic, while the right brain uses intuition. When starting a new project, the left brain identifies all the important details, when the right brain tries to see the end results with clarity. So who do you see yourself more as, a left brainer or a right brainer? Once you know this, you can use more of the other part of your brain to optimize your life, become smarter, and integrate your spiritual with your material side more effectively. It also adds more joy in your life and you will start to see immediate results. Most successful people are still more of one side than the other, but they realize the power of this concept and they try to use both sides. It will also help in communicating with other people who might use more of the other brain than you do. Right brainers are more kinesthetic and visual. They think in pictures and they visualize. Often they see the outcome of what it is they want to achieve before it actually happens. Then they put their left brain to work to make it happen. The left brain does all the logic and the research. It does the analysis and tells us what steps it is that we have to take. The left brain is more auditory and uses words in this process. Left brainers are good at looking at details, focusing on one thing at a time, being direct and working on their own. Right brainers are good at seeing the big picture, working in groups, multitasking, and focusing on teams. As you can see, to become wealthy and to attract abundance, using both sides of your brain will get you there more faster. Now we talked about your left and right brain, and hopefully you know which one you are and what you can do to use the other side of your brain more effectively. I would like to add another section, which is thinking low and thinking high. Thinking low is in terms of having a certain groundedness, while thinking high is going for your ultimate dreams and goals. A few years ago, I was so depressed. I read a lot of books about spirituality and also on materiality, and I attended tens of seminars around the world on these topics. Most of the people and teachers taught me to dream big dreams and not to settle for anything less than I am. They told me to set high standards and to achieve, or to think about what I want and poof, it will materialize out of thin air because of the law of attraction. Now I set some crazy goals like earning $1 million within a month or buying a house within a week. And how about my goals of getting a six-pack within a fortnight? I even set a goal of achieving Australian residency within a year, which was rejected for 3 times in a row for stupid reasons. But I simply kept applying again and again because some guru told me that if something is a must for me, I will get it. And it makes sense, right? Now, apparently there are some exceptions to the rule, which are things and people outside of your control. In this case, the government of Australia. Of course, I never achieved any of these goals, and as a result, I became very disappointed and depressed with myself. I became addicted to drugs and alcohol, and I felt in a very deep hole. And thank God for that. As a result, I became much more grounded, happier, and I even achieved things I never imagined were possible when I climbed out of this hole. Sometimes to reach to the light, you have to go through the darkness. And when I did my research, I found that most of the successful people in the world have seen the dark side, and as a result, they were able to get to the light and become the people they are today. Many of them have been addicted to drugs, have suffered abuse of some sort when they were younger, or they faced immense poverty. That darkness provided with a contrast to look at what they do want and to go after it. Most people overestimate what they can do in the short term, while they underestimate what they're capable of doing in the long term. It's all about having short-term, lower and grounded goals together with long-term, higher goals to achieve your dreams. You can still set your high goals, but take some more time to accomplish them. Then you can set your short-term goals according to your long-term dreams and work on them every single day. As a result, you build momentum and the law of attraction starts to work indeed because you have a clear vision, you're focused, and you take inspired action. Your reticular activating system starts working in your favor. You set a higher standard for yourself, which will help you to achieve your goals. And you will feel great because every day feels like a win, because you have achieved something. Commit today to working on your goals every single day and start living them. Before you know it, you will have even forgot you have set these goals because you're already living them and you have achieved them and you have set some new goals for yourself. Now, if you haven't already done so, it is important who you are dominantly, a left-brainer or a right-brainer. For the left-brainers under us, you know who you are. You love logic, numbers, routines. You're highly self-motivated and you value facts over feelings. Now try to incorporate some more of your right brain. Next time you do a task, visualize getting the task done. Use some sort of tools like mindstorming or drawing to get your ideas out of your head onto paper. Go more with the flow and try working more with others than just working by yourself. Now come up with 3 more action steps for yourself on how you can improve your life using your other side of your brain, your right brain. For the right brainers under us, you also know who you are. You love going with the flow. You work in groups, you do multiple things at the same time, and you focus on ideas and teams. You see many solutions, and you try to avoid conflict. Now it's time for you to use some more of your left brain. Commit to doing one thing at a time until it's complete. Bring some sort of structure into your life in areas where you're currently not very structured. And next time feelings come up with certain things, also check the facts around them to see that they're congruent. Plan your day in advance and look at the details as well. Now come up with 3 more action steps for yourself on how you can improve your life using more of the left side of your brain. We also talked about thinking up and thinking down. Are you an up-thinker and set very high goals for yourself? Try breaking them down into bite-sized chunks that you can work on every single day to achieve them and to create momentum. Or do you only think down and you don't even set high goals or just set comfortable goals? Start to visualize more goals and set 1 year, 5 year, and even 10-year goals and dreams for yourself. From these goals, you can then create your short-term goals and achieve them with ease. I would like to end this segment with a quote from Dr. Seuss. Think left and think right, and think low and think high. Oh, the things you can think up if only you try.